hello, I'm really excited. We've got a brand new build coming with an Intel 13th generation. We're going to get the ball started with this motherboard. This is a Gigabyte. We've used their motherboards in the past. We've loved them. In fact, I still use one on, I believe I was using an AMD processor in the one that I'm still using. This is an Aorus Z790 or Z790, depending on where you are and how you want to pronounce this. This is the master edition of this gaming motherboard. Now, keep in mind, if you've got a very powerful processor, you want to get the motherboard and all the functionality that you can to go with it. So we're going to first unbox it and then talk about the various ports and so forth that are available on there. If you like these videos, please give us a thumbs up and of course subscribe. That really, really helps us out. You'll notice that these things are very well protected. They're still using foam, so that's okay because this is a very critical component of any system. And of course, for those of you who are not that familiar with assembling a whole system on your own, from scratch, custom, the motherboard really has all the components built in. When you get one of these, you get, of course, this is the motherboard, which I'll show you in a moment. They still give you a lot of nice little stickers. And there is also a little booklet here. And on the bottom, unlike in the past, you're getting less and less cables. And the reason is, in the past, you'd have SATA drives, you'd have IDE drives, you want to go way back. Since a lot of the drives now are NVMe or M.2, they go directly on the motherboard, so no need for cables and wires and so forth. Now, keep in mind, if you're doing this, you're not getting, as you may be able to tell, there's no power supply, there's no... So this is really a component. You're going to need a case, you're going to need other things to get this to work, including, of course, a power supply. So this is... basically comes like this. Let's go ahead. And by the way, if you're going to manipulate any kind of electronics, make sure that you're well grounded, that you have, you're not going to shock the component, or that will have very negative consequences on the part. All right, so what you'll see is there's a lot of metal on here, and of course this is to dissipate the heat off the motherboard. So this is one way that the higher end motherboards deal with having higher components, faster CPUs. This is an LGA 1700, so that's the 13th generation processor of Intel, will fit in here, so an i9, i7, and so forth. And they're quite easy to install. There's a little plastic here to protect the connectors on here. When you actually get the processor, which we'll do a video on, you simply open this up and the processor goes into here. Now, keep in mind that so when you buy one of these, it doesn't come with a processor. It doesn't also come with the other major component, the RAM, the memory. So this motherboard has DDR5. So you're getting higher frequencies. And of course, as we go along, you're getting higher capacities for memory. So now you'll be able to get much more memory on these motherboards. So as you can see here, we have you're able to put four sticks of memory in here. So if you're putting in, 32s, and you can really start to get some very decent memory out of these. Okay, so look at the heat sink on this thing. So you've got an M.2, and do keep in mind that this is a PCI 5. So for those of you who are aiming for faster and faster speeds in your drives as well, this thing, so you've got a little... you take off the little plastic on the bottom, it will stick to the M.2 drive. And if you, I don't know if you can see the heat sink here, but it's just enormous. So this will dissipate the heat, no problem, off of this one. So that one's the main one. And if we take off this, you'll notice, look at that. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wow, so you can really go to town on this. So you've got quite a lot of storage space. It's pretty impressive. So let's take a quick look at the back, where you'll find most of the ports. So you'll have not only Wi-Fi, this is Wi-Fi 6E, so it's the latest you can get right now, or you could also plug into this red port here, which is a 10G port. So if you want to go wired, that's the way to do it. Get increased speed. And of course, you won't be subject to environmental concerns in the sense that there's no interference and so forth on most wired connections. Apart from that, you're going to find a lot of USB. You're going to find an optical audio, and you're also going to find some jacks, so headphone jack and, of course, a microphone. Now, you've got USB-Cs on the bottom. These are 3.2. And you've got a solitary display port there on the bottom. Of course, when they designed these, they're expecting you to buy a GPU and put that in to drive multiple screens. So that is really there for configuration early on. Very few people will have a single screen these days, but if you do, I guess you could drive it directly there. Of course, this is meant for gaming, so they're really expecting you to get a GPU. The rest of it is pretty boring. So that's the motherboard in a nutshell. I'm Bob Pellerin, CTO Bob. Please subscribe to watch the rest of our build. And of course, you can leave us some comments below. We'd love hearing from you and seeing what you think of this. And you can reach us at www.ctobob.com. We'll see you in the next video. Thanks so much for watching.